Early on in Blacksite, we talked a lot about why we wanted to do this creature versus that creature, this enemy type versus that. You know, each one should serve a role in the game, or should have some bit of character or some flavor, or should evoke something. But while the game's plot revolves around the Reborn Insurgency, we also put a lot of thought into the different Xenotypes that appear in the game. We've got a bunch of different classes of Xenos. We have some large ones, of course, like, you know, the Firebrood is the size of a house, practically, and their entire encounter is built around fighting it. It's a lot of fun. We have three different classes of these things that the soldiers sort of commonly call the Flatheads. They're these massive worms that range in size from 8 feet. I think we have a 12-foot version, and then we have like a 25-foot version, and then we have one in the game that's just humongous. You fly around in a helicopter. We call it the Jumbo, and it's sort of crawled out in the middle of the night out of the ground, and its lower body, which you finally get to see, is wrapped around this massive bridge that collapses during the fight. And then we've got this thing called the Drudge, which the soldiers kind of commonly call Octopus Dog. And our initial idea with the Drudge was that it's just going to be crawling all over the place, and we looked at, you know, urban myth in places like Iraq with the camel spiders and things like that, and we started sort of in that direction. But what we ended up with was two different classes of the Drudge, and they climb and jump and run through the world. In addition to the Flathead and the Drudge, we've got little creatures that run at you and pop like firecrackers. They try to explode on you. They're like crawling IEDs. Called the Scrabs. We have a monstrous Xeno called the Spore Tower, which basically rides the wind and lands, expands, and starts spawning other types of Xenos. And there's a mini game around popping some armored hotspots on that creature. So we use all these creatures in combination, again, just to vary the gameplay. We're totally into the whole alternation of gameplay thing. We also fictionalize that there are human beings infected with some of the xenospores that are spreading across the United States in the game. And we call the infected people, we call them bug-ridden. And the fiction of the game is largely allegorical to fears about global warming and global pandemics and things like that. And the bug-ridden are kind of like our version of infected, rage-filled humanoids.